Rider. Who did this to you? Looks like a goodbye letter. Zahedi, I found an outrider. He was hanged. He left a goodbye letter. It says something about a secret outrider onk.
Why do you?
I think I know where to.
Please, I don't want more trouble.
I'm not going to hurt you. Did something happen?
I'm awful. You all look the same to me. He tore down the door and he carried my friend Monique away. Fucking altered to take whatever they want.
Not like that.
Really? Could you find her for me? I'm Lucy. I'd make it worth your while.
You're Lucy. You know anything about some guy living in a hatch with a outrider symbol?
Outrider. Yeah, I remember the guy. He left me with something. A key with the outrider symbol on it. Tell you what. You find Monique for me, and it's yours.
God knows what that altar is doing to her!
It seems I need to help this lady if I'm gonna get my hands on that Outrider's key.
You see what they're talking about?
That's the opposite of a welcome mat.
Work and work to keep this place.
place nice, and you come stomping in with blood and
guts.
I suppose I should be bowing down to you, kissing your feet for letting me in your goddamn presence.
From a whorehouse, a little gratitude.
Gratitude? How about all the times I've wrapped my legs around you and I get nothing, nothing?
Enough with the complaining already.
I thought life with an altar was
going to
be exciting. I thought there'd be armies
down
your feet. And...
you need rescuing.
Hey, what is it? Who's there?
How am I supposed to know? And that fucking altar to my face. Do I look like I need rescuing?
Hold on. I'll destroy anyone who gets close.
Oh, yeah, sure. Just as soon as you get your pants up from your goddamn ankles.
Yeah, as soon as I do that,
there's pants. Oh, yeah, and all I do is, like, sit and I clean here, and you're always in...
I really don't know which of those two to feel more sorry for. I should get back to Lucy, at least. Put her mind at ease. Found your friend. She's in no danger. She's, living happily ever after.
Really?
No. She's driving the guy crazy.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds more like Monique. I was so worried. If there's anything I can offer in return.
I'm good, thanks. But about that key...
Of course. This crazy drunk used to come in here all the time, professing his undying love, until finally he drowned in his own vomit. He used to tell these crazy stories about some buried treasure, something to do with the old Outriders. I wouldn't know where to start looking, but... here. If you find any real treasure, make sure to bring some back for old Lucy, won't you? Hey, good luck finding that treasure. I bet you'll turn something up.
It's not gonna be around here. That old quarry would be a good place to look.
Ain't nobody.
we have here? I found some kind of hidden bunker with an Outrider insignia painted on the floor.
I thought all the Outriders had died long ago.
I guess some of them ended up here, but why? And where are they now? I knew the guy who wrote this journal, Sergio Acosta. He was down here long enough to raise a son.
In that bunker? For his entire life.
The kid's name was Mercer. He bugged out. Acosta went searching for his son in the forest.
This isn't gonna take you. You were all mad then.
Maybe Acosta or Mercer are here. I should ask around if I want to solve this Outrider's bunker mystery.
What can I get you?
That's a nice coat.
You're an Outrider. I thought they were all dead.
Not yet. Where'd you steal it from?
This old thing. My mother passed it to me. Her dad was an Outrider.
Oh, shit. Who was he?
His name was, Jack Tanner. Knew him?
Tanner was a good man. He was my captain. Saw him die, trying to save us from landing on this godforsaken rock. It's an honor to meet you.
Yeah, well, he's probably rolling in his grave about now, seeing what I've become. You buying something or what?
Your father, Sergio Acosta. What happened to him?
You know him?
Only in passing.
Well, he was smart enough to survive the jungle the first time, and dumb enough to give it a second try. And it was all my fault that he did.
What happened?
Look, my parents were fucking possessive. I spent my whole life living in a stupid bunker, making the greatest sacrifice to protect humanity, they'd say. But you know what? They never told me what the hell we were protecting. One day I had enough, so I ran. But my dad wouldn't let it go. Tried following me to find me, to save me. A fool's errand.
Sounds like an outrider, all right.
Some time ago, the scout said he stumbled upon the remains of his expedition in the jungle. But I could never bring myself to go there. But if you happen to find it, would you bring me back something of his for me? Picture of my mom he wore on a chain.
I'll look for your father.
You come back anytime you want another shot. I owe you that much, at least.
Now I know where to find Sergio Acosta. He probably has the bunker key with him. Hey, Mercer. How'd you survive it? Spending your whole life in a hole in the ground.
Oh, it wasn't a life. I grew up in a cage. The first time I figured out how to open that front door, it was beautiful. After that, I was just a trapped animal, plotting my escape.
Hey, your parents kept you safe. A lot of people would have happily traded places with you.
I'd rather have a shorter life. Up here in the fresh air.
the Outriders expedition. What's left of it. Acosta's body must be among the remains. Okay, got Acosta's key.
This isn't gonna take.
I've been seeing Shadow.
You see my wife?
What can I get you? Thank you. At least I can put her to rest now.
Hey, you. Newbie. Over here. Everybody needs a little something-something, am I right? I'll give you a good deal.
What can I get you?
You know, a small dump.
Now back to the Outriders bunker in the quarry.
You keep your distance.
Watch where you're going, friend.
This
is the last.
This isn't gonna take the win.
Hey, Doc. Never exactly thanked you for pulling me out of cryo.
I wasn't convinced you felt I had done you a favor.
Well, I guess I prefer being conscious, regardless of the circumstances.
Not everyone would agree. But you do seem particularly well-suited to these times, Outrider.
What exactly were you and Jane doing out there anyway when you found me?
Scavenging tech in the old ruins. I honestly thought I'd scoured half the planet, but I had recently found an old notebook of my father's. In it, he described those first months on the Flores floating over Enoch. How the landing had been delayed, and the anxiety about sending the Outriders down.
Anxiety? What do you mean? Outriders are always meant to go down first.
But if, as it turned out, the planet didn't end up proving exactly habitable, there was no plan to get you back up to the Flores. You were sent on a one-way trip.
Yeah, they never told us that part, but it's not surprising. Shit. That explained why Maxwell was calling the green light no matter what.
Anyway, I'd never heard the story. And it suddenly occurred to me, this Maxwell who called in the green light, he must have had a way to contact the Flores. An uplink. There had to be an uplink on this first drop pod, and if I could find it...
And you did. Your briefcase. That's Maxwell's uplink in there, the world's last hope. How fucking poetic. Jack Tanner's daughter, Sarah. Seems she took his place in leading what was left of the Outriders.
She was one of the few that fought back when the ECA had the Outriders court-martialed. She saved many Outriders' lives. But she disappeared after that, didn't leave a trace.
Seems this bunker is where she ended up. Her last entry says she walked off into the forest in search of her husband and son.
By herself? She could have been hoping to survive.
None of us came into this hoping to survive. If anything...
You know, I wouldn't have reckoned...
You made us proud. Outrider till the end. Zahidi. I found Sarah Tanner. She made it further than any other expedition. Tough, like her dad. The final key. Time I paid that bunker one more visit.
Hey, Doc, something that's been driving me crazy. Can you explain to me how we're still able to use radios when the anomaly distorts the signal, our probes, anything long range?
That's it exactly. We're using analog shortwave radio on a high frequency band without a lot of power, which means we can communicate over short distances. A digital signal like the one we're tracking has a far greater range and is less prone to interference. Still, over a large enough distance, the anomaly will distort it.
So, as long as the anomaly's around, we're stuck with analog.
Analog equipment is...
Whatever they were defending, we're almost in. Zahidi, the Outriders were stockpiling weapons in this bunker. A whole damn lot of them.
How many are we talking?
Enough to hold off the apocalypse, and then some.
Fuck me. Zahidi, I think I'm staring at a nuke.
A thermonuclear bomb? I wonder Tanner's daughter was willing to give her life to keep that hatch closed. I think you might be very wise to close it again and throw away the key.
Zahidi, something's happening. The machines, they're crashing.
You need to get out of there before it explodes.
Warning, safety control failing. Missile launch imminent. Warning.
Okay, that's not good. What do I do?
I don't know. You think I know anything about nuclear bombs? Wait. Is there a refrigerator around?
A refrigerator?
Yeah, a fucking refrigerator. You know what a fucking refrigerator is?
Yeah, I found it.
Oh, thank God. Now get inside.
What?
Get inside the refrigerator. The light will protect you.
That is the stupidest idea I've ever heard.
I saw it somewhere.
That's not gonna happen.
Countdown to launch initiated.
Wait, that's weird. Okay. There's a slot for a key.
Listen to me. You gotta move fast. You've got company. Insurgents just rushed the hatch.
113. 112. Well, that sounds great. Any ideas where we might hide some keys?